Are you fucking kidding me? This is just my day. Already. It's only 10 o'clock in the morning. Okay. Welcome, guys. Welcome back to the channel. So we are working on, as the title suggested, building a scoreboard today in No Man's Sky. And people are, you're probably thinking, why, right? Why would you be building a scoreboard in No Man's Sky, a space exploration game? Well, because it has a killer build sub-game. And I've been trying to find, like, odd ways to use the build menu. And some of the things that they put in there for what seems to be no real apparent reason, other than just fun. So, that's what we're doing. Welcome to the Galactic Foosball Center for the Elderly. Upon completion, I think it's going to be renamed, you know, the Boldly Going Nowhere Foosball Center Stadium. I don't know, something fancy and sounds like a football stadium kind of name. And it will be the sponsor. Alright, so the first thing we need to do is build our and/or latches on our two floor switches that are going to trigger the score, which is going to be this one and that one. This is going to be the easy part. Okay, so this is our power. Do I not have that wired the other way? So I guess the outgoing power. Weird, man. I swear I thought it was the other way. Am I just... I don't know. Okay. I'm thinking too hard on this. So we're going to get out our switches, and we need two power inverters and two auto switches to start. And let's just put them all on this panel, because that's something else I've been having to watch lately. And I'm going to get the hell out of here. This is... I don't need to be standing there. Alright. Good Christ. Hope you guys aren't getting car sick. Alright. So this is an and/or latch. XOR latch, whatever you want to call it. I believe people in the business actually call it an and/or. Okay, so this is going to connect to both the pass-through intake, whatever, and the switch itself, or the, you know, the middle, the conditional portion. These are going to go straight up. This is going to have direct power input from you know, whatever, from a electromagnetic generator. And that is your and or latch as soon as we have power coming in. So let's find that and get it going. That'll work. Let's bring you right up to here. We'll just call you good right there. Such, and then this can just go up. Such, okay. So that when you press on this, no matter how long you stand on it, it's only going to allow 1 second of power to go through at the end. So basically, that turns this into a push button, which is awesome. For multiple reasons, because A, you can only allow 10 push buttons per base, no matter what, which is, I just don't understand. I don't understand why. I'm sure there's a coding reason for it, or maybe it's just a way of keeping us from going too crazy. Maybe the game can't handle a whole lot of that. I don't know. But, hey, we'll figure it out. Now on the back side, I'm going to put the batteries for this actually on over here instead of on the inside, just because I want a cleaner area to work with, and I'll just close it up later. It'll be fine. So let's get what am I doing? We're closing up this right here. See any of this right now. All right, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 panels. That's easily more than enough. So so I was kind of helping out Alex last night. I say I was helping, I was probably more in the way than anything. And I had gotten up and walked away first to help my wife with something and came back and found out I had died because of a storm that had come by, and I was outside and, you know, no big deal. And I was talking to him about, oh yeah, when you die, you just come over here and you click on your grave and, you know, I put all the stuff back in your bags. Well, I guess while I was explaining that to him, I never clicked on it, and I left. And the place I was at, I had gotten there by going through a portal, you know. I was actually trying to help him reach a destination, working on his living ship, which didn't really work. And then so I had left and went back through the portal, went back to what I was doing, and that's when I realized, I left everything back there. Everything that was in my bags is all gone. Which, I mean, really, I'm not out anything because I have farms available everywhere for everything. So I just do is go around and pick it all back up. And I need actually to go up to the refiner. So one of the other neat things about this particular base is that it's not just a working foosball table. There is a welcome center when you first come in. You know, this is the size of those little statues that I was going to try to use for foosball men. But if you come around on the back side here, there is a completely working kind of shop base area. All the amenities that you're going to need right away for, you know, your storage, refiners. You can check your power, you know, if you really want to here. Yeah, man. And I was going to put a nutrient processor over here, but there's nothing worth... I mean, there's no reason to really cook here. So, we need sodium nitrate. Alright. Let's put half of that in here. And we'll put the other half in here. Speed that up a little bit. How many did I need? 60? Was that what it was? Or 100? Great. So, what are you guys doing these days with this pandemic that's going around? Here we are in the last day of April. You know, let me know what you guys are doing in the comments. How are you getting by, you know? We are simply just getting by, you know? Neither of us is working, so I've got a lot of time to play this game. So, you know. Let's keep that one in there. We're going to take this one out, I think. And get back to it. Right here. Wow. Whoa. Alright. Magnetized ferrite. Why did I fucking get sodium? Pardon my French. I needed it anyway. Is it here? No. 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 Maybe. Ferrite dust. Damn it. Okay. I used to have the personal refiner, and I just got rid of it the other day. That would have been handy here, because I could have just been making the stuff as I needed. So I'm going to need ultimately 10 batteries, which means I'm going to need 1,000 of this stuff by the end of the day, just to make what I wanted to make here. Oh, you know what? It's actually going to be faster to just go to my magnetized ferrite farm and collect. So let's go do that. And let's do it at the proper place. Instead of acting like an idiot. So. So. We are looking for ferrite faucet. It's probably going to be at the end. There it is. So, hey, I've got one viewer. I wonder if it's somebody I know. That would be exciting if it wasn't. All right, so I am currently at ferrite faucet. Just gonna collect a little bit here. There's still 20 grand, 21 grand left here. I don't remember if all these 2750, yeah, these must all be connected. Welcome to ferrite faucet. Should probably put some lights in here someday. Excuse me. So, back to the foosball table. This is so awesome. I am so excited for this. I cannot wait to get this finished and show it off. Maybe get a few people up here and make a promo vid. I'm going to work on getting the, I'll get the portal address and the coordinates. That way anybody that wants to come here can and use this thing and have fun, which is the point. Alright. And I'm not going to worry about the refiners up there. I'll get more. Alright, back to batteries. Okay, so I need 5 batteries. I've got 5 panels. Shit, which side of the board am I on? Okay. The away team. Okay, the GEC scoreboard is on that side, so we really need to be over here. But is this where I made the switch? On this side? I did not. So, oh no, I did. Okay. So I'm on this side. I don't know. Why am I backwards? That's the GEC. Okay, so yeah, when the GEC's. Okay. Jesus. There we go. Okay, so 5 batteries. Man. Just gonna think about this. I had it. Probably just for the ease, the way I had done it at the test area. So we're going to make these little half things here instead of a full thing, because we don't need a full to hold our batteries. I don't like that running through that thing. But we're going to do it anyway. Okay. A good clean build really helps if you are kind of still working on your idea, if you're kind of theory crafting. Just a clean work area just can't be replaced, you know? There's a lot less setbacks too, if you accidentally delete the wrong power cord, which I've done hundreds of times. Well, hundreds. Tens of times. Okay. Switches. Okay, so first we're just going to make this the self-closing capacitor that it needs to be. So first, we're going to make this one the self-closing capacitor that it needs to be. And you know what I think we're going to do? Just to make this stuff even easier for me to build, because I like easy. Alright, so this is going to be the GEC side. And this will be your first point. This will be your fifth point. I guess we'll just go across just for... One, two, three, four, five. Could I have done that any more fucking backwards looking? Whatever. Okay. Okay. All right, so this is going to come directly. I want to put it directly under here for cleanliness. And we're going to go up a little bit, because it doesn't need to be as open as it was. In the workbench. Hi, brother. You don't say. What is that right there? What is that? Oh, okay. No, it's just the back side of it. No. Okay. Alright. Hi, Regulus. What's up, brother? I know. Are you thirsty? Or are you just wanting to be loved? Yeah. Come here. Let me pet you. Let me love you. Yeah, good kitty. Okay. Man, I gotta think about this for a second. Okay, so this is gonna be our incoming power from the switch. Is that right? No. No, this is our incoming power from a power source. Okay, so the outgoing, or rather the incoming from the switch, we're going to put down shorter. Okay. Now. It's 10 o'clock. Alright, I may or may not be having a visitor coming by as well, so I may have to drop my stream for a little bit. But let's get as much of this as we can going here. You know what? Let's just go straight. We're going to go straight across, y'all. When I say straight, we can't quite do it straight. Alright. Oh, what the hell is that connected to? Because I don't think it's that. I didn't just fucking delete something that was important. What was on the back side of that? Ah, Jesus. Of course I did. Is that actually still going out? town. Yes, okay. And that is a inflowing power source, so we may as well make use of that. That we'll just connect there. All right. Now, this one is going to go into the battery, then the battery is going to come back down to here. And that is the self-containing, don't charge me more than once at a time capacitor. Power comes in, it passes through, goes up. When the foot switch is triggered, this comes up, turns this on, allows the power to go up into the battery and back down, and switches the power inverter to an off position, no longer allowing the power to flow, which means it all goes in and gets stuck in there. I have a video on how that works, creating a capacitor, or an egg timer, or something like that. Anyway, this is a variation of that because it doesn't have a countdown drain. It'll have an immediate-ish drain when it's done. When the final battery is powered, the rest of these will drain simultaneously. All right, now I need to go back and look at how. Man, because over there I've got it set up such that it's all just all on the same wall. But over here it's not. Which is not a big deal, actually. Here. We will just go ahead and build it here like it's all on the same wall. And when we're done, we'll just run the line from the battery to the light I put here to the battery on the wall. So, plus that way we'll be able to visually test it here. So this is going to go, let's see, we need T-switches, up, okay, how do I want to place this? Just like so. Okay. Okay. So from here, you are going to, and this is part of your drain setup. Alright. So the battery, if there's power in here, it's also going to be a conditional yes or no. Does this have power? If so, open the auto switch. Okay. Oh, except the last one. Ooh, shit, the last one is different. So. We need to have incoming power. Okay. that will have a constant flow of power coming into one half of the switch. And then the battery, when it lights, will go into the other one, and this power will power also, coming out of this switch, that light. As such. Okay, so... we've got the lights, and the first... so we need to make four more of those. Then we need to make the switches at the bottom for the incoming power and the drain. And we'll be done. And then connect all the lights. So let's get to it. Back to switches. Okay, we're going to put it on all. Connect these to the right thing, so how about that? Inside. Silly. Alright. It doesn't have to be, I guess, the inside one, but just for my visual purposes, it seems to help to make it come through in a loop-de-loop. I don't know why. It just does. Okay, so that's done. Let's get this. Fuck. Where did my switch go? Okay, it's there. Weird. Okay. Oh, was it there the whole time and I was just looking at this one and freaking out? Probably. Okay. So these are gonna come out just a little bit, I think. And sorry, I'm being quiet real fast, texting my daughter. Waiting on ace. I just saw that. Tell ace, I said, hey. Or you could throw in some of the old Starship Troopers lines. We're the old men now, ace. Texted my kids. Oh.